Hello, I'm Thomas Poole from Carrigbegory, County Wexford. We're here in Tara Hill today cutting silage. We're right beside in the southeast, right beside the sea. As you can see in the background, if we go any further, we're in the sea. I got hit the pit silage here last year. I bought an A20 class Jaguar off Kelly's and Burrs, which you can see walking here in the background. Donald Kelly is driving her here today. She's going well. I got into pit silage because I was working for a man at pit silage and he retired from pit silage. So from there I bought a TM120 and a New Holland A360, which is here drawn today. I was drawn for this man that I was cutting silage, driving the harvester for. I had two tractor trailers hired into. I had my eye on a harvester back in the years a little bit to take over the silage from the man that was retiring. And I was in Kelly's Burrs and I found this A20 at a bar, and we went straight to work. It was coming into silage season and we went straight to work. Kelly's done a few bits on it for me and we cut last year with her. It's gone well. A few little problems with the pickup there, a few little small bairns went, but Kelly has great service. I can't praise him enough. His store man was there at 12 o'clock one night when we got a breakdown. And we had the harvester going next morning, cutting at 8 o'clock. She's not mad horsepower, she's 300 horsepower. We're cutting about 60, 70 acres a day. Any more, she won't be able for any more than that. That's her going rate, and I like that because my machinery, I have three trailers, my loading shovel is a 412 Farmaster, which is hired in from another contractor, Ben Weeks. We work together a little bit, and I like to keep it smart, and if you were to ask me whether I was going to get much bigger, the answer would be no. I have room for another few customers and I'd leave it at that. I'm not going to go up to a harvester for 600 horsepower and take on a couple of thousand acres. I can't see it. I'm going to keep going the way I'm going, keep it small, keep the finance small. If I'm working late at night, I like to work for myself and not the finance man. I bought the A20 because she was fitting my money bracket, and she's easy maintained. I knew a bit about the classes. I had to go for class because I was driving a class, and I knew the ins and outs of the class. In the winter time there, a man come from Cork, and me and him maintained the harvester. We went in from the front and out the back and put a few liners in the chute and done a few ins and outs of it. I had it ready to go before silage started. There's no point in getting the harvester ready when you get a phone call, silage on the ground. So I know the ins and outs of her. She's cheap to run. She's diesel-wise, she's probably working out per acre not too bad compared to the 890 I was driving, probably better. If I go to a bigger harvester, I'm going to have to change everything else. And I think that if silage is going into a pit too fast, it's not being rolled enough. And the secret to pit silage is to roll it and get lots of roll. If you have air in the pit, bad silage, not happy cows. The operators that's with me, the workmen are good, and I hope to continue to come back to me next year. Like, you tell them something in the morning and just do it and there's no problem. And I just like to see silage coming out of that chute the whole time, and I'm happy.